here for, I was thinking about it, this may be for a lot of these students their first real full band performance ever. These were the students that started on instruments remotely. And the first group that I want to thank tonight before we begin started are their elementary band directors for doing the impossible. I know how hard it was dealing with those situations up here with students who had knowledge of what they were doing. I can only imagine how difficult it was with beginners. Needless to say, they did come up here a little behind where sixth graders normally are. We struggled the first 2 weeks even to stay together because they were so used to playing individually instead of as a large group. It's much harder to do this because accuracy is so important. They learn very quickly, oh, if I hold something a little too long or I cheat a rest, or it makes a difference. So it took a while to get used to that. But the one thing they did have was a lot of enthusiasm and willingness to work hard. And because of that, they have four really diverse pieces to perform for you tonight. So I'm really proud of them. I know that you'll enjoy what they've prepared for you. Our first piece is called West Wind Overture. It's by Anne McGinty. An overture is an opening, usually to a show. It's written that way as to be inspiring and uplifting. This is in ABA form, which means it's got an exciting opening, a softer middle part, and then it goes back to that opening theme again toward the end of the piece. So we hope you enjoy West Wind Overture. Change instruments for the good of the group. When this group came in at the beginning of the year, we had flutes, clarinets, alto saxes, trumpets, a couple of trombones, and drummers. And even if they were the best players to ever come into our school, the amount of different sounds that you can have, or different tone colors you can have, having all of the instrumentation that a full concert band has, will only make it better. I said to the kids, if you try to color a fall landscape picture, but you were only given two crayons, purple and green, no matter how good an artist you are, it's really hard to do a fall landscape. But if you have the whole box of crayons, think of what you could do. It's the same thing with sounds in a band. So I just quickly want to recognize Leah John and Hilary Murata added bass clarinets to our group, which was wonderful. Vihan and Leslie added tenor sax. Martine and Viniac, thanks to them, we have two French horns in our band. Mark switched from trumpet to euphonium for us. And probably the biggest switch, Magenta, who was brave enough to go from flute to tuba. So thanks to them, I have a lot of colleagues in other districts that are very jealous of my instrumentation in the sixth grade band. We also had a lot of beginners that decided to play for the first time. I'm really proud of them. It's not an easy thing to start something brand new in middle school, and they're doing great as well. Again, they've been very open to everything that we've offered to help make them a full, better group, and I hope that they continue to play together as this group for the next 7 years. Our next piece is an orchestral transcription of a very famous work. That means it was originally written for symphony orchestra strings, and then was rewritten for wind band. This is probably the most famous theme from Brahms Symphony No. 1.
Thank you.
our next piece is an interesting one. This was their favorite when we first started working on things because it was so different. It's called Thunder and Lightning, and rather than being a melodic piece that you would go away humming, it's a tone poem, paints a picture with sounds. And in this one, they get to use their instruments in some non-traditional ways to help create sound effects. Some of the effects are really hard to hear, and we're gonna try to exaggerate them so you get the full effect. But from start to finish, you should be able to picture a thunderstorm off in the distance, making its way to us, and then passing overhead and passing us by. So we hope this works, and we hope you enjoy it, and please don't get wet. Continue to hear the growth of these kids. I'm excited to see what they can do by spring. above and beyond.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're going to slow things down with a very pretty ballad called In This Quiet Place. In our next selection, I just wanted to recognize a couple of people on stage. Each year, we try to tweak our instrumentation so that we have more of the sounds of the different instruments that we're missing. And this year, we had a couple people that were brave enough to try something. It's usually something bigger and usually takes a lot more air, and it's not any different this year with this band. So I'd like to recognize Marwan, who switched to the Barry sax, the baritone saxophone, and Kenzie, who switched to the tuba. Kensley actually switched to the tuba from the euphonium, and we don't have any euphonium in the 8th grade band, so he's doing double duty tonight, and he'll be playing all the songs of the 8th grade band on euphonium as well. Our next piece is an arrangement of the very popular New World Symphony by Antonín Dvořák, a Czech composer who then resided in the United States. This is going to be in three movements, so we would ask that you hold your applause until the end of the third movement. In the second movement, you'll hear a little bit of a duet by Laura Lee Rosada on trumpet and Courtney Tyrone on French horn. We hope you enjoy Suite from the New World.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now, we were not able to fit all of the audience for the 6th, 7th, and 8th grade here, which is why we did a little bit of a split tonight. So you already missed the 6th graders, and if you didn't get a chance to see them, you know, because you didn't have anybody else on the stage with the 7th and 8th grade, you can still check it out on video. We do have video on the go recording tonight's concert, and we will be sending out the link to all of the band students, so you can check out 6th, 7th, and 8th grade, as well as our grand finale sometime tomorrow or in the future. We're going to finish our 7th grade portion of the concert with a piece called Brass in the Basement by Larry Neek. This is kind of a fun, light-hearted little piece, and it's called Brass in the Basement, and that's basically referring to the lower instruments of the band, the bass instruments like the low brass and low woodwinds. So a lot of the time, they don't get a chance to show off their musicality in terms of playing melodies much. The melodies are more suited to the higher instruments because the voices carry over the band easier. But this was craftily composed in a way that really features all these instruments that don't usually get a chance to be featured as much. So we hope you enjoy Brass in the Basement.
Appreciate that so much. even during dress rehearsals, they, through their actions and just the way they acted and the way they were supportive of the other groups, it means a ton. It means a ton to the other players, the younger players, to get approval from the older band, and they've just been wonderful people as well as wonderful musicians. So we thank you for that. Their first piece is called Arabian Dances, and it does sort of paint a picture. If you think of nomads out in the desert coming to the end of a day, the sun is going down, they light a fire, music starts, and different groups start dancing. There are three different groups of dancers that you'll actually hear. One is in our low brass and woodwinds, one is in the upper brass, and then upper woodwinds. Eventually, all three of these dances combine together. There's actually an indication in the music that tells the students to be wildly festive. So we thought this would be a good opener for the eighth grade part of the concert. We hope you enjoy Arabian Dances. I almost forgot to announce, this piece starts slowly and it features two of our players with some solos. So Maida Babalala will open this with a beautiful clarinet solo, and that will lead into a little flute tag played by Smriti Jarawala.
continue our program with the eighth graders with the Douglas Wagner arrangement of the Percy Grainger piece called Colonial Song. Now, this is a piece that's actually very near and dear to my heart for a couple of reasons. First, the way he wrote this, he actually composed this in 1911 and then rearranged it for military band in 1918. It's that version that is the more popular version. The one we're going to play is an arrangement of that. But the Colonial Song version from 1918, that version is one that I actually got a chance to play several times with the band that I play with called the New Jersey Wind Symphony. Many years back, we took a tour of Eastern Europe. We went to several countries, and we got a chance to play this piece, and I was the trumpet soloist on this. So it's partly, you know, a big part of me because of that, and the other part is just, it's a gorgeous piece of music. The melody itself is actually used in another one of Percy Grainger's pieces called Australian Upcountry Tune. He is originally a native, or was originally a native from Australia, moved to the United States, and this piece, Colonial Song, was written as a tribute to the wonderful, beautiful people and land of Australia. So we're going to play, again, an arrangement by Douglas Wagner of Colonial Song, and this will feature a trumpet solo by Rishi Singhal. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
piece takes us to the British Isles. Beyond the Hedgerow is a medley of three pieces that originated, one in Ireland, one in Scotland, one in Great Britain, but most eventually made their way to the United States and are recognizable tunes here as well. The middle section, the middle one, is a slower piece, and you will hear solos by Urchica Roy Chowdhury on flute and Ali Romaine on trumpet.
Just like with the seventh grade band, we have a few students up on the stage here with the eighth grade. that have been brave enough to try out a new instrument this year, and they're all doing a great job with that, so I'd like to just recognize a few students. Sri on the oboe. Nathan on tenor sax. And Johanna on the percussion section. So our last piece with the 8th grade band is one from the movie Avengers Endgame. It's soundtrack highlights from Avengers Endgame. And this is written by Alan Silvestri, who's done numerous film scores, some of which you may recognize. Forrest Gump, Back to the Future. And a neat little thing about Alan Silvestri is that he grew up right in New Jersey in Teaneck. So we hope you enjoy Avengers Endgame. Thank you. Thank you very much. We were really excited to play that one for a live audience. We haven't gotten a chance to do that. The last time I tried to do this with a band here at Brooklawn, it was during the pandemic, and we did it in a recording session, which is not nearly as gratifying. So thank you for being such a great audience. We're going to make our little transition now to the combined finale with both 7th and 8th grade, so just give us a few seconds and we'll be right back with Let It Snow. Alright, so just pretend they're not shuffling around behind me. I'd like to just do a couple of quick announcements before we get to our finale. I'd like to just thank a few people. First of all, the administration for our district, as well as for our building here at Brooklawn, for being so supportive of the arts and music. And we really do appreciate that so much. This year, we have a new supervisor, Ali Caravano. I'd like to thank and also welcome to the district as our very first music supervisor who is actually a musician. So it's very exciting for all of us. That's okay. I'd also like to thank Mrs. Hazel and Mr. Austerlitz, our chorus and band, chorus and orchestra directors here at Brooklawn. Yes, I did say orchestra. I'd also like to thank our superintendent, Dr. Sargent, for bringing strings to the district of Parsippany. This is the first year that they have reached Brooklawn as sixth graders. We put together a 6th, 7th, and 8th grade orchestra with our very, very first middle school orchestra concert this next Wednesday, right in this room. So come and check that out if you can. Also, I'd like to invite you to check out the future events in your program, and to not be strangers and to come by and support all of the music here at Brooklawn. I'd also like to thank our custodians for helping to set up and break down every other day with all the needs that we have with all these large ensembles. And lastly, I'd like to thank our chaperones tonight for helping out with a little bit of a different format in this concert. Before we get to our finale, I did miss a solo bow for two of our 7th graders in the second movement of the New World Symphony. I'd like to just recognize now Laura Lee and Courtney. And I'd like to thank all of you for coming out tonight and being a great audience and supporting music here at Brooklawn. It's a little bit warmer out than it usually is at this time of year. I mean, ski club for tomorrow night is canceled because of rain and warmer temperatures. So I think it's only fitting that we play Let It Snow, Let It Snow, Let It Snow.